man of the day, Mr. Sherman, senior congressman, Dr. President of Sindhi Foundation, dear Sufi Legari, dear Dr. Amarani Shah, respectable guests, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. First of all, I pay my thanks to Sindhi Foundation for inviting me to be here today as a speaker. And I do appreciate the efforts always being taken by the Foundation for raising the issues of sin in the United States. Really, this is an honor for me to be here in the event of giving the honor to the Congressman Brett Sherman on the commendable efforts of protecting the rights of the Sindhi people, language, culture in the US Congress. Dear Sherman, you deserve a lot on what you have done for Sindhi and the Sindhi peoples in the Congress. Your name is Sherman. You know, sir, in Sindhi, Sher means lion. So, I titled you as a lion man of a Sindh and the Sindhi people in a US Congress. Really, you are so brave, vocal and vigilant to raise the questions of every issue of a Sindh. I do appreciate that you are a co-chair of a Sindh caucus which focuses on the issues of importance to the Sindhis in Pakistan, including the human rights abuses and the preservation of a Sindhi language and the culture. Dear sir, your questions raised in the Congress, letters to the Pakistan government and speeches on the rights of a Sindh are very much important and have a significant impact. If today Sindhi program is run on the voice of America, I am very much sure that it is all because of your voice in the Congress for the Sindhi language. If today USAID in Sindh is funding on the some development projects, it is because of you that you pointed it in the Congress and about the proper utilization of the funds in Pakistan. Whatever is being done by you, it is a remarkable, but still the destination is so far to achieve what we are striving for. Still we are living in such a condition where our identity as a Sindhi secular and a Sufi nation is on the stake. Sindh United Party is a national democratic party of the country that considers Pakistan as a multinational federation. Consists on the historic nations and their motherlands. Our party is reformist in its political ideology and firmly believe in the non-violence, tolerance and peaceful coexistence. our party believes in keeping the state and political affairs to be separated from the religion and maintaining the peaceful relations with the neighboring countries through the non-interference in their internal affairs. Pursuing the historical and cultural and civilized traditions of an industrialization, we want to bring an end of a discrimination on the basis of a gender, color, creed, religion, beliefs and a language. We respect the human dignity and freedom of an individual rights of live and let to live. Since the inception of Pakistan, there are three fundamental issues of the state. One is aligning the religion with the state affairs. Number two, denial of a historic nations in the Federation of Pakistan. They were the historic nation, now they have become a nationalities of the Pakistan. But the Pakistani state is denying it. Relationship with the neighboring countries and the world. Third issue is that. So the solution must be pursued around these issues. If today the religious extremism is prevailing in Pakistan and in the region, it is because of so-called two-nation theory of Pakistan. When it is being claimed by the state that it is a Muslim state and the rule of Islam is the fundamental instrument of the state affairs, then the peace and harmony in the region will be always under threat. We strive for separating the religion from the state affairs, and in this regard, we are expecting from the world and the world community, especially from the United States, to support the secular, national and the real democratic forces in Pakistan. We demanded and created the Pakistan as a federation consist of a historic nationalities. But since its formation, the national identity of the federating units was denied. By force, it is imposed to accept the national identity as a single Pakistani nation. We believe that without harmonizing the common interest, we cannot become our nation. At present, the national interest of each nationality in the Federation of Pakistan is in conflict with the interest and claim the national interest of Pakistan. Until and unless the national interests of historic nations are not admired and safeguarded, the true look of a federation cannot be viewed. So we demand from the world community to support the secular and the national and the real democratic forces in Pakistan for their autonomous national identity in the Federation of Pakistan. Unnecessary involvement in the internal affairs of neighboring countries has created a security problems in the region. We believe that the Pakistan should maintain a good relations with the other neighboring countries, particularly Afghanistan and India, through non-interference in their internal affairs. This will reduce the tension on the borders and defense budget. The funds so saved shall be spent on the development of a country to bring about peace, progress and prosperity. Once again, I am thankful to Sindhi Foundation and our chief guest, Mr. Sherman, to give me this opportunity. I am thanking to the whole Sindhi community and my friends. I am thankful. I hope that mostly I presented the political issues. I think that Pakistan's basic principles are the political issues. Three basic issues which I have mentioned. Once again, I want to repeat it again. One is the aligning the religion with the state affairs. Second is the denial of historic nations in the Federation of Pakistan. Sindhis, Punjabis, Pashtuns, Baloch, they are the historic nationalities of Pakistan. Relationship with the neighboring countries and the world community, we must realize that how to live in the world and in the neighboring, with the neighboring countries. So these are our fundamental issues which, since the Pakistan is created, these three problems have not been solved because of the state policies. Thank you once again.